Welcome to Lab 4, Creating a Global Policy. Let's review. In Lab 1, we installed the multi-domain server. In Lab 2, we installed the DMS, the domain management servers. And in Lab 3, in the previous lab, we created local policies, local security policies, one for each domain, and then we installed the local security policies on each domain's security gateways. In Lab 4, in this lab, we're going to show you how to create and install a global policy. The previous lab, Lab 3, was just a prerequisite for this lab. In the previous lab, we had to create and install local policies first before we can do the global policy installations. Now, a global domain is automatically created when we install the MDS server. And so in this lab, we're going to log into the global domain and create the global policies with global rules, and then assign the global rules to the local domains to the local rule bases. This will append the global rules to the local policies to the local rule base. Let me show you what I mean. Again, I need to launch a Smart Console. When I launch a Smart Console, I can directly log in to the global domain if I want to. But here instead, let me log in first to the multi-domain, the MDS domain. In the MDS server, we see all the domains that we created back in Lab 2. And also, and you probably have already noticed, that there is another domain, what we call the global domain. It was automatically created when we installed the MDS server, the MDS1 server, way back in the first lab, in Lab 1. Okay, let's now go ahead and open Smart Console for the global domain. In the global domain, we can create global policies. If you remember, in Lab 3, we created three local policies, and those policies had some duplication, some duplicate rules, and some duplicate objects. What we want to do now is in the global domain is to simplify local policy creation by substituting repetitive local rules with a single global rule. Okay, notice that in the global domain, there is no gateways or service created. And also, there is no policies created yet. So let's go ahead and create a policy first. Let's select Manage, Policies and Layers. Now select New Policy. Let's call this policy the Global-Policy Standard. Let's disable Threat Prevention. We're not going to enable this for now. Select OK. Select Close. And so now we have a policy with no rules. You probably already noticed that in the local domains that we had a few duplicate and repetitive rules. We had pretty much the same rules in all three domains, and we had duplicate rules. We had rule 1, which was the junk noise drop rule. And we also had the last rule, the cleanup rule. Those two rules were duplicate rules across all three domains. What the global domain allows me to do is to create global policies of repetitive rules. And so here, let's create both of those repetitive rules. Let's add some rules. So the first rule we're going to add is rule 1, the noise rule. We're going to call this the global noise rule. This rule will block from any source to any destination, and it blocks all NBT traffic and also blocks BOOTP traffic. And also, we're not going to do any logging on this rule for this traffic. Notice that we created this rule above the placeholder rule. The placeholder rule is not a rule per se, but it represents the domain's local rule base. This placeholder rule will be replaced by the local policy rules when it is assigned to the local domain policies. And so now next, below the placeholder rule, we will create another rule. This will be the cleanup rule. I'm going to call this the global cleanup rule, which is an any rule that drops traffic. And we're also going to log this rule. Okay, one more thing. I also want to create an object, a duplicate object. So here, let's create a host object. In all the local domain policies, I had a DNS rule with a local DNS object. And so now instead, I want to create a global DNS server object with the IP address of 8.8.8.8. Let's OK to this. I will show you later where and how to use this global object in the local rule base. Now, we'll need to publish this global policy. Notice the message. The message says that we need to use the MDS Smart Console to update the global policies to the domains. And so that is the next thing we need to do. We need to assign this global policy to the local domains rule base. But we cannot do that from the global policy. We cannot install a policy from the global domain. There is no install icon. There is no installation icon here in the global smart console. And so let's close this global smart console first. And just like the message said, we need to use the MDS smart console to assign the global policy. And so we need to install the global policy from here, directly from the MDS smart console. But before we do that, I need to do some housekeeping. Let's first reopen the Domain X Smart Console, because I need to clean up the rule base a little bit. I want to delete all the repetitive domain local rules. I want to delete the local noise rule and also the local cleanup rule. So let's delete rule 1. Say yes to continue. I'm also going to delete the last rule, the cleanup rule. Now this rule base seems incomplete, but you'll know why I did this in a minute. And so now let's publish this. Notice that I only published this rule base. I did not reinstall this policy. So now let's close Domain X Smart Console. And now back in the MDS Smart Console, we're going to install the global policy. How do we do this? We need to go to the multi-domain, the global assignments view. Note that here, there is currently no global assignments, at least not yet. So let's do one now. Select assign, select the new assignment tab. Here is where we need to select the global domain. And also the domain I'm going to assign this policy to is the domain X domain, the MDSX. Also, I only have one global policy, so I'm going to select the global-standard policy. This is the global policy that we just created in the global domain. I'm not going to assign any threat prevention policies. Now select assign. And now select publish and assign. This global policy is now being assigned to the X domain. And that's how easy it is to assign a global policy. Now the task is completed successfully. And so let's close this. Okay, let's go back to the domain view. Let's reopen the Domain X Smart Console once again, so that we can see how this looks, how the local domain rule base looks. I want to show you how the domain policy looks like now since we assigned the global policy. We should have the global rules being appended to the local rule base. Okay, here we go. Notice that the first rule is the global noise rule. And that's the one we created in the global policy. And it's grayed out, meaning we cannot edit or delete it from here. because it's a global rule. And here we're looking at the local policy. Now look at rule 2. It's the local domain policy. Notice that this is an inline layer, an inline rule. It's called the domain layer. So let's expand that. And here are all the local inline rules. We have the update rule, the management rule, the stealth rule, and also the DNS and the DMZ rule, and also the outbound rule. And these are all the local domain inline rules. And the last rule is once again a global rule. It's the global cleanup rule. Okay, one more thing I want to do is in the DNS rule, I want to delete the DNS object. This is the local DNS object. And I want to replace this local DNS object with, instead, a global DNS object. Notice the G in front of this object name that tells us that this is a global object. Okay, the last thing we need to do is to install this combined policy. This combined policy that has local rules with embedded global rules. Okay, and that's it. I'm going to end this video right here. You will just need to repeat all the same steps on domain Y and also on domain Z. You'll need to assign the global standard policy to domain Y and also to domain Z's policies. If you need help, you can just rewind this video and you can repeat the last few steps for both of the other two domains. Okay, and that's the end of this video. And also, that's the end of this course. I truly hope you found this information informative. This was just another quick jumpstart training course with a brief introduction to the multi-domain security management server product. And so have a good day, see you next time, and bye for now.